Hello students, we are going to start geometry and trigonometry now. If we observe the question paper of RMO every year, there are generally two questions from geometry and trigonometry out of six. So this is quite important chapter for RMO purpose. The result of trigonometry are much important while solving the problem based on geometry. So we will start this chapter with some standards of trigonometry. The first thing we have to remember is triangle identities. There are some standards which are true for every triangle, and we have to remember these standards. So first standard is, in any triangle ABC, sine 2A plus sine 2B plus sine 2C is equals to 4 sine A sine B sine C. Similarly, next standard that we have to remember is cos 2A plus cos 2B plus cos 2C is equals to minus 1 minus 4 cos A cos B cos C. Similarly, the third one is tan A plus tan B plus tan C is equals to tan A into tan B into tan C. So we have to remember these three results. Similarly, there are three more results which are very important. Next one is sine A plus sine B plus sine C is equals to 4 cos A by 2 cos B by 2 cos C by 2. Next one is cos A plus cos B plus cos C is equals to 1 plus 4 sin A by 2 sin B by 2 sin C by 2. And the last one is tan A by 2 into tan B by 2 plus tan B by 2 into tan C by 2 plus tan C by 2 into tan A by 2 is equals to 1. So basically there are six standards, 3 plus 3, and we have to remember these standards so that we can solve the questions and we can apply these standards into the questions directly. These all standards are valid in any triangle. The only necessary condition for these standards is that A plus B plus C must be equals to pi and all angles are positive. So now we are going to solve some questions based on the triangle identities. Here we have a question: find the radius of incircle of given triangle. The diagram shows that this is a triangle and the incircle of this triangle is drawn. Now there are three circles which touch the sides of triangle as well the incircle of the triangle. The radius of these circles are given as R1 equals to 1, R2 equals to 4 and R3 equals to 9. So what will be the radius of this circle which is incircle of triangle given here? So to solve such type of question, first of all we know that if a circle touches two lines, then its center lies on the angle bisector of given two lines. So I am drawing an angle bisector here. If I draw the angle bisector, this angle bisector will pass through the center of smaller circle as well from the center of this incircle also. In the same way, if I draw another angle bisector, that will pass through the center of this circle having radius R3 and also from the center of the incircle of triangle ABC. Let's say we give the name of this triangle as ABC. Now, if we draw a line which is passing through the center of this smaller circle and parallel to the base BC, and if I draw a vertical line from in center of triangle ABC, let's say that is I, so we formed a triangle, a right angle triangle here. This is 90 degree angle. What will be the angle here? What will be this angle? I'm talking about this angle. This angle is clearly angle B by 2. Why this is equal to B by 2? Because BI is actually the angle bisector of angle B. We know that in center is the point of intersection of angle bisectors. So BI is clearly the angle bisector. That is why this angle is equal to B by 2. If we assume the radius of in circle is R, then the total length of I from BC is R. But what about the this length, means the perpendicular of this right angle triangle? This is R minus R2 actually. And what is the distance between centers of these two circles? Circles means one of which is in circle and another is this circle having radius R2. The distance between centers will be R plus R2. So in this right angle triangle, we can easily find the value of sine B by 2. What is the value of sine B by 2? That is perpendicular R minus R2 divided by R plus R2. So is there any result related with sine B by 2? Because similarly, we can find the value of sine A by 2 and sine C by 2 also. Is there any standard related with sine B by 2? So if we observe the triangle identities again, we can see here, there is a standard related with sine A by 2, sine B by 2, that is standard number 5. But at the same time, we should know the value of cos A, cos B, cos C also. So the better one is the sixth result. Sixth results includes the terms related with tan A by 2, tan B by 2, tan C by 2 only. So in this question, we are going to convert this term sine B by 2 into tan B by 2. If we find the value of tan B by 2, so tan B by 2 is actually perpendicular by base. Perpendicular is R minus R2 and base will be square root of hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. So that will be 2 times root over of R R2. Alright. In the same way, we can find the value of tan A by 2 also. Tan A by 2 is R minus R1 by 2 root over of R into R1. And similarly, we can write the value of tan C by 2, which is R minus R3 by 2 root over of R R3. Alright. Now we are going to use the sixth standard which we have learned in triangle identities. And we are going to use the values of tan A by 2, tan B by 2, tan C by 2. Also, we know the values of R1, R2 and R3. R1 is 1, R2 is 4, R3 is 9. So with the help of that standard, we can find the value of R which is required here. So how we are going to use that values? First of all, what is the value of tan A by 2? So tan A by 2 is R minus R1 by 2 root over of R into R1 into tan B by 2. Tan B by 2 is R minus R2 by 2 root over of 4R. Clear? We have substituted here the values of R1 and R2 plus tan B by 2. Tan B by 2 is again same, 2 root over of 4R into tan C by 2, that is R minus 9 by 2 root over of 9R plus last term is tan C by 2, which is R minus 9 by 2 root over of 9R into tan A by 2, that is R minus 1 by 2 root over of R, which is equals to 1. This was the standard. Tan A by 2 into tan B by 2 plus tan B by 2 into tan C by 2 plus tan C by 2 into tan A by 2 equals to 1. From here, we can easily form a quadratic in R and we can find the value of R from here. So let's solve this quadratic. This is R square minus 5R plus 4 by 8R plus R square minus 13R plus 36 by 24R plus the third term is R square minus 10R plus 9 by 12R is equals to 1. Then we can write, we can take LCM here and further we can simplify this equation as 3 times R square minus 5R plus 4 plus R square minus 13R plus 36 plus 2 times R square minus 10R plus 9 is equals to 24R. Or we can write here 6R square minus 72R plus 66 equals to 0, or R square minus 12R plus 11 equals to 0, or R is equals to 11 or 1. We know that from the diagram it is obviously R cannot be equals to 1. So the value of R will be 11 and this is the final answer. So how we have used triangle identities here, and we can solve this question very easily using triangle identities. I think everyone is getting how to solve this question using triangle identities. Next, we have to know a result which is sine rule. Sine rule in any triangle If ABC is a given triangle, we denote the opposite side length of angle A, B and C as small a, small b and small c. So sine rule says that the ratio of any side to the sine of opposite angle is constant, which means A by sine A is equals to B by sine B is equals to C by sine C. So we have to remember this result, and how this result is coming. Just look at the diagram. If we draw an altitude from A to BC, let's say this point is D. So we can find the length of this altitude using simple trigonometry from the two triangles, triangle ABD and from triangle ACD. So what is the length of AD? From triangle ABD, if we find, we know this angle is B. So we can write it like C sine B. Also from the triangle ACD, we can write it like B sine C. So if we equate these two terms, we are getting C by sine C is equals to B by sine B. Similarly, if we draw some other altitude, then we will also get the result that this is equals to A by sine A. So we have to remember this result, and we can apply this result into the questions directly. Also, we have to know that what is the value of A by sine A or B by sine B or C by sine C, because we know that all these terms are equal. And this is equals to actually 2R, where R is the circumradius of triangle ABC. Why this is true? We are going to prove this. Suppose we have a triangle ABC and we have drawn its circumcircle. Let the center of this circumcircle is O. And we have to prove that A by sine A is equals to B by sine B is equals to C by sine C is equals to 2R. So these three terms are equal. We know it by sine rule. And what is the value of this term which is equals to 2R? We are going to prove this. So to prove this, what we are going to do is that we will draw a line from B joining O that intersect the circle at a point. Let's say we denote this point as A dash. All right. And if we join A dash to C, we know that this angle A dash CB is 90 degree. So this is the diameter of circumcircle. Let the radius is R. So this diameter is 2R. If we apply sine rule in triangle A dash BC, then what we get? We get that A dash B by sine 90, that is equals to BC by sine A dash. All right. A dash means B A dash C angle. This one. We also know that if we apply sine rule in triangle ABC, what we are getting? We are getting AB by sine C is equals to BC by sine A. And we also know that this angle A and this angle A dash both are equal angles, because chord of circles are equal angle at any point of the circumference. Okay. So sine A and sine A dash are equal terms. So if we observe these two equations, equation number one and equation number two, so right hand side of both the equations are same. That means left hand side are also same. So we can write AB by sine C, or AB, we can denote AB as C. So C by sine C is equals to this term. And this term is A dash B. We know that A dash B is diameter of circumcircle. So it is 2R by sine 90, that is equals to 1. It means C by sine C is equals to 2R. So finally, we got the value of this constant term, that is A by sine A or B by sine B or C by sine C, which is equals to 2R. So we have to remember these results. Next is cosine rule. We should know what is cosine rule in any triangle. Let's say we draw a triangle ABC. This is triangle ABC. Opposite side lengths are denoted by A, B and C. So cosine of any angle, let's say cosine of A, we can write it like B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC. Or similarly, we can write the value of cos B as A square plus C square minus B square by 2AC. So this is cosine rule. We can write the value of cosine of any angle of triangle in terms of the side lengths. So cos A, cos B and cos C can be written like this one. We are going to prove this. How we are getting this formula? So to prove this formula, First of all, we should draw an altitude. Let's say we are drawing an altitude from vertex A of the triangle, and let the foot of altitude be D. So let's say length of BD is X, so obviously the remaining portion means CD will be A minus X. From the two triangles ABD and ACD, we can use Pythagoras theorem to find the length AD square. So from the first triangle, we can write AD square as C square minus X square. And from the second triangle, we can write the value of AD square as B square minus A minus X square. If we solve this equation, we can easily find the value of X. The value of X that we are getting is C square plus A square minus B square by 2A. Alright? And if we know the value of X, so we can clearly write the value of cos B from triangle ABD. In triangle ABD, if we find the cosine of this angle B, we can write it like base by hypotenuse, which is C. And if we write the value of X here, we will get the value of cos B as C square plus A square minus B square by 2AC. Alright? So I think it is quite clear to everyone. Value of cos B is C square plus A square minus B square by 2AC. So we should remember this formula, how to write the value of cosine of any angle of triangle in terms of the side length. Now we have some questions based on sine and cosine rule. The first question is, in a triangle ABC, D is a point on BC such that AD is internal bisector of angle A. Suppose angle B is equals to 2C and CD is equals to AB, then prove that angle A is 72 degrees. Just see how we are going to solve this question. First of all, we have to draw the diagram according to given condition. We have a triangle ABC. So here is the triangle ABC. As per question, D is a point on BC such that AD is the angle bisector, means these two angles are equal. This is equals to this one angle. And angle B is twice of angle C. So let angle C is theta. So angle B will be equals to 2 theta. And we know that the sum of the three angles is 180 degree. So remaining angle A is 180 minus 3 theta. So of course we can write it 90 minus 3 theta by 2. And this is also 90 minus 3 theta by 2. Reason is quite simple. AD is angle bisector of angle A. So there will be two equal half. Alright everyone. Now one more information is given to us that CD is equals to AB. So let's say length of CD is L. So this is also L. Now we have two triangles here. One is triangle ABD and other is triangle ACD. In both the triangles we have two sides equal and one side is also common to both the triangles, that is AD. Let the length of AD is X. So if we apply sine rule here, we can find the value of L by X from both the triangles. We know that the ratio of sides is equals to the ratio of sine of opposite angles of those sides. So L by X from triangle ABD, we can write the angle opposite to X is 2 theta. So in the denominator, there will be term sine 2 theta. In the numerator, angle opposite to L will be, this is 90 minus 3 theta by 2 and this is 2 theta. So the sum of these two angles is 90 plus theta by 2. So obviously angle D will be 90 minus theta by 2. Alright. So in the numerator, we will get sine 90 minus theta by 2. The same value L by X we can find using sine rule in triangle ACD. So in triangle ACD, if we find the value of L by X, so that will be equals to sine of angle opposite to L, which is sine 90 minus 3 theta by 2 divided by angle opposite to X is theta. This is sine theta. So if we solve angle theta from this equation, then we will be able to find angle A. So we are just going to solve this equation. Numerator is cos theta by 2 divided by 2 sine theta cos theta. That is equals to cos 3 theta by 2 by sine theta. So you can observe here, we can cancel sine theta directly. And further, we can simplify cos theta by 2 is equals to 2 cos A cos B. That is equals to cos A plus B which is 5 theta by 2, plus cos A minus B, that is cos theta by 2. Alright, that means cos 5 theta by 2 is equals to 0, which means 5 theta by 2 is equals to 90 degree. That means theta is equals to 36 degree. Alright, when theta is 36 degree, so what is angle A? We know that angle A is 180 minus 3 theta. Alright, so 180 minus 108, that is equals to 72 degree, and this is what we have to prove. This question was asked in the year 2001, and this is a very simple question based on the sine rule. So using sine rule, we can easily solve these type of questions. One more question is here. In triangle ABC, let D be midpoint of BC. If angle ADB is 45 and angle ACD is 30, determine angle BAD. The similar kind of question is this one as the previous was. First of all, we have to draw the diagram. So it is given to you that ABC is a triangle. D is the midpoint of BC here. It is given to you that angle ADB, this one is 45 degree. Also, angle ACD, this one is 30 degree. So we know that this angle will be 15 degree, of course. Sum of two interior angles is equals to this exterior angle. Now we have to find angle BAD. We have to find this angle. Let this angle is theta. So we have to find the value of theta. How we can find the value of theta? Here again, we can see two triangles. One length AD is common to both the triangles. Let this length is X. And also we know that BD equals to CD. Let this is L and L. So again, we are going to use sine rule in the two triangles. One is triangle ABD, another is triangle ACD. And we are going to find the value of L by X from the two triangles. What is the value of L by X from triangle ABD? Angle opposite to L is theta. So this is equals to sine theta by angle opposite to X is 135 minus theta. So this is sine 135 degree minus theta. That is equals to the value of L by X from the triangle ACD will be the angle opposite to L is 15 degree, that is equals to sine 15 degree, divided by the angle opposite to X is 30 degree, which is sine 30 degree. So we have to just solve this equation for theta. We can write it like sine 135 minus theta by sine theta is equals to sine 30, which is 1 by 2 by sine 15 degree, that is root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 2. Further, we can write sine 135 minus theta is sine 135, that is 1 by root 2 into cos theta minus cos 135, which is minus 1 by root 2 into sine theta, divide by sine theta, that is equals to root 2 by root 3 minus 1. Then further we can write it like cot theta plus 1 is equals to root 3 plus 1, or from here we can write cot theta is equals to root 3, or from here we can say that theta is equals to 30 degree. This is also a very simple question. We have found the value of theta using sine rule here. One more question we have here. If sides of a triangle are three consecutive integers and the largest angle is twice of the smallest angle, determine the triangle. Means we have to find all the three side lengths of the triangle. The given information is that the sides of triangle are three consecutive integers and the largest angle is twice of the smallest angle. So first of all, we are going to draw a rough diagram. So let's say triangle ABC is given here. We assume the smallest side AB as n minus 1. This is the smallest length of the side. Next is n, and third one is n plus 1. So we know that the smallest angle will be angle C. Let this is theta, and it is given that the largest angle is 2 theta. Alright, so angle A will be 2 theta here. Now we have to find the value of n. We have taken sides as n minus 1, n, and n plus 1 because the sides of triangle are given as three consecutive integers. First of all, we are going to use sine rule here, and we can write sine 2 theta by sine theta as the ratio of opposite sides, which is n plus 1 by n minus 1. But here we have unknown n and theta. We can simplify the left hand side as 2 cos theta. Sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. So sine theta will be cancelled and 2 cos theta will be equals to n plus 1 by n minus 1. Also, we can find the value of cos theta using cosine rule. So value of cos theta, A means cos C. Cos C will be equals to A square, that is n plus 1 square, plus B square, that is n square, minus C square, which is n minus 1 square, by 2n into n plus 1. Alright? If we substitute the value of cos theta here, if we substitute the value of cos theta from here to here, then we will get 2 times numerator can be simplified as n square plus 4n divided by 2n into n plus 1. That is equals to n plus 1 by n minus 1. And now try to solve for the value of n. So 2 cancelled, numerator is n plus 4, denominator is n plus 1. That is equals to n plus 1 by n minus 1. Then we will get n square plus 3n minus 4 is equals to n square plus 2n plus 1. So n square again cancelled. And the value of n we are getting as 5. So, of course, the three sides of triangles will be 4, 5 and 6. Clear, everyone? So, here we have used sine rule and cosine rule simultaneously and we got the side length of this triangle ABC. Now, we are going to study some standards related with different centers of triangle. The first one is circumcenter. Circumcenter is the center of circle which passes through all the three vertices of a triangle. If we consider triangle ABC, then its circumcenter is generally denoted by O, and O is a point which is equidistant from the all three vertices. How circumcenter is obtained? Circumcenter is actually the point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors of each side. If we draw perpendicular bisector of side BC, if we draw perpendicular bisector of side AC and perpendicular bisector of side AB, these three bisectors will pass through same point, which is the circumcenter of triangle ABC. We should know that the circumcenter of an acute angle triangle lies inside the triangle as shown here in the diagram. But when the triangle is right angled, the circumcenter will become the midpoint of hypotenuse. If the triangle is obtuse angle triangle, then circumcenter lies outside the triangle. We should also know that the distance of circumcenter from each vertex is equal to R. This is capital R, and capital R denotes the circumradius of triangle. So the distance of O from each vertex is R, but the distance of O from each side, we have to remember this formula, the distance of O from side BC or distance of O from side AB. How we can find this distance? Let's say the point is D here and we are interested to find OD. So just observe the triangle BOD. We know that if side BC subtends an angle A at the circumference, then the side BC subtends angle 2A at the center O. So the angle BOD will be equals to A again. And we know this is right angle triangle whose hypotenuse is R. So of course OD is equals to R cos A. So we have to remember that the distance of circumcenter from any side, like side BC, is R cos A. If we are interested to find the distance of circumcenter from side AB, so the distance of circumcenter from side AB will be R cos C. R cos C is the distance of O from AB. Alright. We have to remember these standards. Here we have to also derive the formula of circumradius R. So circumradius R, we have noticed that circumradius R was also used in sine rule. So in most of the cases, we generally find the circumradius using sine rule. Also, there are some more formula related with circumradius. We know that area of triangle ABC, if we denote area of triangle ABC as delta, so area can be written as 1 by 2 B into C sine A. Alright. And also we know that A by sine A is equals to 2R. So in place of sine A, what we can write? We can write sine A equals to A by 2R. So if we apply the value of sine A here, then we will get delta is equals to half BC, and in place of sine A, what I am going to write? A by 2R. So from here we can find the formula of R, that is ABC by 4 delta. So apart from using sine rule, we can also find the value of R from this formula directly, that is ABC by 4 delta. The next is in center. In center is the center of a circle which touches all the sides of given triangle. So if we assume triangle ABC, let's draw a diagram. Here we have triangle ABC, and this is a circle which touches all the three sides of triangle ABC. Let's say its center is here. So we denote the center of in circle as I, and I is actually called in center. This I is equidistant from all the three sides because this circle touches the three sides of triangle. So these three lengths are always equal, and we denote these lengths as small r. Small r is the in radius of triangle ABC. So first of all, how we get the in center of triangle? Actually, in center is the center of circle which touches all the three sides actually. So this is the center of circle which touches AB as well as BC. So obviously its center lies on the angle bisector of AB and BC. So if we draw the angle bisector, that will pass through I. If we draw another angle bisector, let's say angle bisector of angle A, then that will also pass through I. So in center is obtained by drawing the angle bisector of the three angles of triangle ABC and the point where the angle bisector intersect, that is the in center of triangle ABC. We know that the distance of in center from the three sides of triangle is always equals to R. But what is the distance of in center from vertices? So we are going to derive the formula to get the distance of in center from any vertex, and we have to remember this formula. Actually, we know that this angle is B by 2. This is B by 2 because BI is angle bisector. And we know that this perpendicular, this is right angle triangle, and the perpendicular has length small r equals to in radius. So BI will be equals to R by sine B by 2. All right. Or it is R cosec B by 2. So the distance of in center from vertex B will be R cosec B by 2. Similarly, the distance of in center from vertex A will be R cosec A by 2, and the distance of vertex C from in center I will be R cosec C by 2. So as we have remembered these distances in case of circumcenter, similarly we have to remember in case of in center also. At the same time, we have to learn the formula of small r in radius. So if we join I to C, then we can observe here that the total triangle is divided into three triangles: triangle AIB, triangle BIC, and triangle CIA. So if we know the area of triangle ABC, so this total area can be divided into three parts, that is equals to area of triangle AIB plus area of triangle BIC plus area of triangle CIA. We know that in general, we denote the area of triangle ABC as delta. What will be the area of triangle AIB and area of triangle BIC? First of all, look at triangle BIC. So BIC has base equals to small a. We denote the length of BC as small a, and height is small r. So area of triangle BIC can be written as half a into r. Similarly, area of triangle AIB can be written as half c into r, and area of triangle CIA can be written as half B into R. So we can observe here, we can take R common and remaining part will be A plus B plus C by 2, and we know that this is denoted by semi-perimeter S. So R will be equals to delta by S. This is the formula we generally use to find in radius of any triangle. Small r is equals to delta by S. At the same time, we use some more formula. We can relate small r with capital R also. The relation of small r with capital R is small r is equals to 4r sine a by 2 sine b by 2 sine c by 2. We have to remember this formula also. Also, r can be expressed as the tan of angles. That is equals to s minus a tan a by 2. Or we can represent R in terms of tan B by 2, which is S minus B tan B by 2. or we can write small r as s minus c tan c by 2. If we remember all these formula, then it will be quite easy to solve question and to apply these formula into the questions. Here we have to also derive the formula of circumradius r. So circumradius r, we have noticed that circumradius r was also used in sine rule. So in most of the cases we generally find the circumradius using sine rule. Also there are some more formula related with circumradius. We know that area of triangle ABC, if we denote area of triangle ABC as delta, so area can be written as 1 by 2 b into c sine a. Alright. And also we know that a by sine a is equals to 2r. So in place of sine a, what we can write? We can write sine a equals to a by 2r. So if we apply the value of sine a here, then we will get delta is equals to half bc, and in place of sine a, what I am going to write? A by 2r. So from here we can find the formula of r, that is abc by 4 delta. So apart from using sine rule, we can also find the value of r from this formula directly, that is abc by 4 delta. Next is orthocenter. So as we know, orthocenter is actually the point of intersection of altitudes of any triangle. There are some properties of orthocenter. So let's draw the diagram first. So let we have triangle ABC and we have the three altitudes AD, BE and CF. The point of intersection of altitudes is generally denoted by H, which is orthocenter of triangle ABC. So orthocenter of acute angle triangle always lies inside the triangle. Orthocenter of right angle triangle is the vertex where 90 degree angle is formed, and orthocenter of obtuse angle triangle lies outside the triangle. So here what we have to remember is how orthocenter is found. It is actually the point of intersection of altitude. The next thing is the distance formula of orthocenter from sides as well from vertices. So the distance of orthocenter from sides, if you are interested to find the distance of orthocenter from side, let's say we are going to find HD distance, then how can we find HD distance? We know that the sides are denoted by ABC, so this AB side is denoted by C, so of course this BD length is equals to C cos B. Alright, in right angle triangle ABD we can find BD as C cos B. Also we can find one angle, this angle is actually 90 degree. So all of you know that if BEC is right angle triangle, then this angle is 90 minus C. So we can write HD by BD as tan 90 minus C. Clearly HD is equals to BD, BD is C cos B into cot C. Cot C is actually cos C by sin C. So C by sin C can be written as 2R. So finally we came to know that HD is equals to 2R cos B into cos C. Alright, so distance of orthocenter from side BC is 2R cos B cos C. Similarly, if we write the value of HE, the distance of orthocenter from side AC, that will be equals to 2R cos A cos C. And similarly, we can write the formula of HF. Now we are interested to find the length AH. AH means distance of orthocenter from vertex A. So how we can write the formula of AH? In the similar way, suppose we are interested to find AH, so in right angle triangle AHE, we can say that this AE length is equals to C cos A. Alright. So if we know AE, then we can find AH, because we know that this angle is equals to 90 minus C, and hence cos 90 minus C can be written as AE by AH. So clearly AH is equals to AE. AE is C cos A by cos 90 minus c, that is sin c, and c by sin c can be written as 2r. So this is equals to 2r cos a. So distance of orthocenter from the vertex is 2r cos a. Similarly, if we are interested to find the distance of vertex b from h, so bh can be written as 2r cos b. Here we can relate these distances with the distances of circumcenter from sides. We know that the distance of circumcenter O from side BC is R cos A, and distance of orthocenter H from vertex A is 2R cos A. Alright. So we have to relate these distances also, which are important for proving some theorems in the later stages. Next is centroid. As we know, the centroid is point of intersection of medians of a given triangle. So let's draw the diagram first. So here is the triangle ABC, and D, E, F are the midpoints of side BC, C and AB respectively. Then these medians are congruent at point G, and this G is called centroid of triangle ABC. We already know some properties related with medians and centroid, that centroid divide any median in the ratio 2:1, 2 from vertex and 1 from side. So this AG is to GD is 2:1. Or similarly, CG is 2, GF is 2:1, or BG is 2, GE is 2:1. Alright. Here we also have a formula to find the length of median if all the sides are given. So that is called Apollonius theorem. The statement of Apollonius theorem is that if you are interested to find the length of median AD, then we can write AB square plus AC square equals to 2 times AD square plus BD square. Alright, so we have to remember this standard, this Apollonius theorem, and using this Apollonius theorem we can find the length of any median. Next is excenters. So every triangle has 3 excenters. Excenters are the centers of circle touching one side of triangle and 2 remaining sides of triangle when extended. So let's draw a diagram to understand what are the excenters. We have drawn a triangle ABC like this, and we have extended the sides so that excenters can be shown here. So there will exist a circle which will touch BC and AB and AC externally. So I'm trying to say that there will be a circle like this one, which is touching BC and AB and AC externally. So the center of this circle is called excenter. Similarly, there will be 3 excenters. So the excenter which is opposite to vertex A is generally denoted by I1. There will be another excenter here that is denoted by I2, and the third excenter here which is denoted by I3. So how we get excenters? Excenter is point of intersection of angle bisectors, the internal angle bisector of angle A and the external angle bisectors of angle B and C. So the point where these 3 angle bisectors intersect, that is excenter. Similarly, if we want to find excenter I2, then we have to draw the internal angle bisector of angle B and external angle bisectors of angle A and C. Their point of intersection will be I2, and similarly we can get I3. So of course there are 3 circles related with 3 excenters. These are called ascribed circles. So there are basically 3 ascribed circles opposite to vertex A, opposite to vertex B and opposite to vertex C. Their radius are denoted by R1, R2 and R3, small letter R1, R2 and R3. So this is R1, here we have R2. And this, the third circle, has radius R3. There are also formula related with R1, R2 and R3. So the formula of R1, R2, R3 are almost similar to that of R, small r, that is the in radius. R1 has formula delta by S minus A. R2 is equals to delta by S minus B. And similarly R3 is equals to delta by S minus C. we know that small r has formula delta by s. So similarly, we can write the formula of R1, R2, R3. We can relate these formula and we have to remember all these formula. As we have related small r with capital R, similarly we can relate small R1, R2 and R3 with capital R. As we know, small r is equals to 4 times R sine A by 2, sine B by 2, sine C by 2. This we have gone through earlier. Similarly, R1 has a similar kind of formula related with capital R, that is equals to 4R sine A by 2 cos B by 2 cos C by 2. R2 has formula 4R cos A by 2 sine B by 2 cos C by 2, and R3 will have formula 4R cos A by 2 cos B by 2 sine C by 2. There are some relations between R1, R2, R3 and R. The first one is that 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 is equals to 1 by R. We have to remember this relation. Also, there is one more relation, that R1 plus R2 plus R3 is equals to 4 capital R plus small r. So, if we remember these standards, we can directly apply into the questions and we can save time. There are also formula of R1, R2, R3 in terms of tan. As we know, the formula of R was S minus A tan A by 2, or S minus B tan B by 2, or S minus C tan C by 2. Similarly, R1 has formula S tan A by 2. R2 has formula S tan B by 2, and R3 is equals to S tan C by 2. So we have to remember all these formula. The next topic is pedal triangle. So first of all, we should know what is pedal triangle and what are the important properties of pedal triangle. Pedal triangles are basically defined with respect to a given triangle. Suppose a triangle ABC is given. So if we draw altitudes and foot of altitudes from vertex on the sides are DEF, let's say we are drawing the altitudes. So we have foot of altitude as DEF. Then triangle DEF, if we join DE and F, then this triangle DEF is called pedal triangle of given triangle ABC. So first of all, we should know the definition. Definition is, the pedal triangle is a triangle formed by joining the foot of altitudes of a given triangle. Alright, now there are some properties of pedal triangle. The first one is that orthocenter of triangle ABC, orthocenter of triangle ABC is in center of triangle DEF. So first of all, we are going to prove this, that orthocenter of triangle ABC is same as in center of triangle DEF. Actually, AD, BE and CF are the altitudes, so obviously this point is orthocenter H of triangle ABC. Now we have to prove that H is also the in center. So if H is the in center of triangle DEF, that means DH, EH and FH are the angle bisectors. So we have to prove that these two angles are equal. How can we prove this? So to prove this, we should observe that actually this angle is 90 degree. Okay, you can observe clearly, and this angle is also 90 degree. So we came to know that BFHD is a cyclic quadrilateral, because sum of opposite angles is 180 degree. So which is cyclic quadrilateral? BFHD. Alright. So obviously if BFHD is cyclic quadrilateral, then FH is a chord of that circle, and which subtend an angle, this one at the circumference. And what is this angle? This angle is actually 90 minus A. Alright, because AB is the right angle triangle. Here we have 90 degree angle, this is A, so obviously this angle is 90 minus A. So the same angle here will be 90 minus A. Alright, reason is quite simple here, because BFHD is cyclic quadrilateral, so angle subtended by HF at the circumference will be always equal. So this is 90 minus A, so here again angle HDF is also 90 minus A. in the similar way, what we can say that EHDC is also a cyclic quadrilateral. If EHDC is cyclic quadrilateral, so EH subtend equal angle at the circumference. So what is this angle? This angle is again 90 minus A. The reason is same here. So obviously this angle is also 90 minus A. And we have proved that HD bisect angle EDF. Alright, both parts are equal. That means in the similar way, EH is also angle bisector and FH is also angle bisector, and point of intersection of angle bisectors is in center. So orthocenter of triangle ABC is actually in center of triangle DEF, which is the pedal triangle. Alright everyone, so we have to remember this first property of pedal triangle. Second one is, what is the length of side of pedal triangle if sides of triangle ABC are given? Let's say sides of triangle are given as A, B and C. So these sides are A, B, C, and we are interested to find the side length of pedal triangle. Let's say we are interested to find side EF. So how can we find side EF? Listen, in triangle AFE, we know that one angle is A, this is angle A. Also we know that AE is basically C cos A, because ABE is a right angle triangle and hypotenuse is C, so base AE is C cos A. Similarly, AF will be B cos A and the included angle is A. So using cosine rule, we can find EF. We know that EF square is actually equals to AF square plus AE square minus 2AF into AE cos A. Alright, here we have to substitute the value of AF and AE. So what we are getting here, AF square is B square cos square A plus C square cos square A minus 2BC cos cube A. If we take common cos square A, what is the remaining part? This is B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. And because of cosine rule, we know that cos A is equals to B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC. So the whole term will simplified as A square. Then we came to know that EF is equals to A cos A. Means if the sides of triangle are given as ABC, then side length of its pedal triangle will be A cos A. The side which is opposite to small a will be A cos A. The side which is opposite to small b is B cos B. And the side which is opposite to small c is C cos C. Alright. So we have to remember the side length of pedal triangle, which is A cos A, B cos B and C cos C. Also, one more thing we have to remember. What is the circumradius of pedal triangle? If the circumradius of given triangle is capital R, then we have to find the circumradius of its pedal triangle in terms of capital R. So the standard is, if the circumradius of given triangle ABC is capital R, then the circumradius of pedal triangle equals to R by 2. We are going to prove this also. So what is the method to find circumradius? The simplest method is using sine rule. Here we know that this angle is 90 minus A, this angle is 90 minus A. So the total angle will be, this angle EDF is actually 180 minus 2A. Alright. So if we use sine rule in pedal triangle DEF, let its circumradius is R dash. So 2R dash will be equals to the side length EF, which is A cos A, by sine of its opposite angle, which is sine 180 minus 2A, that is equals to sine 2A. And sine 2A, we can cancel cos A, this will be equals to 2 sine A. And we know that A by sine A is equals to 2R, 2R by 2 is capital R, that means R dash equals to capital R by 2. So we have to remember this standard also, that the circumradius of pedal triangle is half of that of the given triangle. Alright. Next is distance between circumcenter and orthocenter. So there is a formula to find the distance between circumcenter and orthocenter of given triangle. Let's draw the diagram first. Let's here we have triangle ABC. This is AD altitude, and we have midpoint of BC as M, and this OM is perpendicular bisector of side BC. So obviously circumcenter will be on OM. Let's say this O is the circumcenter. Orthocenter will lie on the altitude. Let's say H is orthocenter here. We have joined H and O, and we are interested to find the length OH. That is the distance between circumcenter and orthocenter. So how can we find the distance between circumcenter and orthocenter? So first of all, we have to find a triangle whose some sides and some angles are known. Here we are going to find the sides and angles of triangle AHO. As we know that AO is the circumradius, that is equals to capital R. And we also know the distance of orthocenter H from vertex A, that is 2R cos A. This we have proved earlier. Now we are interested to find this angle, angle HAO. So what is angle HAO? As we know that this angle is 90 minus B, alright. Also we know that angle OAC. Why we know that angle OAC? Because if we join O and C, then we know that this total angle is 2B, because AC subtends an angle B at the circumference. So angle subtended at the center of circle will be 2B, and OC and OA are equal. So this is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means remaining two angles will be equal. Sum of the remaining two angles is pi minus 2B. So this part will be 90 minus B. Alright. So total angle BAC is A. Then remaining part which is required, that is angle HAO, that will be equals to A minus 2 times 90 minus B. Alright. What is this angle? This angle is actually A plus B minus 180. And we know that A plus B is 180 minus C. So total angle is B minus C actually. Now if we apply cosine rule, then we can find the side length HO. So HO square can be written as AH square plus AO square minus 2AH into AO into cos B minus C. Alright everyone? And AH square is actually 4R square cos square A. AO square is R square minus 4R square cos A into cos B minus C. Now here we have to use simple trigonometric identities, and we are going to solve it. After solving, we will get HO is equals to R root over of 1 minus 8 cos A cos B cos C. So this is the formula of distance between circumcenter and orthocenter. We have to remember this formula, and we can apply this formula directly into the questions. Similarly, we have to remember the formula of distance between circumcenter and incenter. I am not going to derive this formula right now. We have to remember this formula. The distance between circumcenter O and incenter I is actually square root of R square minus 2R into R, where capital R is circumradius and small r is in radius. Or we can say that this is equals to R root over of 1 minus 8 sine A by 2 sine B by 2 sine C by 2. We have a question here. Let ABC be a right angle triangle with B equals to 90 degree. Let I be the incenter of triangle ABC. Extend AI and CI. Let them intersect BC in D and AB in E respectively. Draw a line perpendicular to AI at I to meet AC in J. Draw a line perpendicular to CI at I to meet AC in K. Suppose DJ is equals to EK. Prove that BA equals to BC. First of all, we are going to draw the diagram as per the information given in the question. as it is given in the question, we have right angle triangle ABC, angle B is 90 degrees. Now angle bisectors AI and BI are drawn, which intersect at I, that is in center. AI intersect BC in D and CI intersect AB in E. So these points are D and E. Now a perpendicular to AI is drawn to meet AC in J. Let's say this point is J. Now we are not drawing K here because K is similarly a point with respect to CI. So first of all, we are interested to calculate DJ length. So if we have calculated DJ, then EK we can write similarly. So what is DJ length? This DJ length we have to find. So we are drawing the perpendicular from I on BC and AC. We have drawn a perpendicular from I on BC, and now we are drawing a perpendicular from I on AC. Let this foot of perpendicular is X and let this foot of perpendicular is Y. Alright. So what we have to finally find, that is length DJ. Actually, we know that this angle is also A by 2. Reason is quite simple here, because this IX is parallel to AB. That is why these two angles are alternate angle, and we know that AI bisect angle A. So this is angle A by 2. That is why here angle XID is also A by 2. Also, we know that IX is actually smaller in radius. So what is length ID? Using simple trigonometry, we can find that length ID is equals to R sec A by 2. Alright. Now, if you see in the triangle AIY, so can we find this angle? Of course, because it is given that AIJ is 90 degree angle. Because we know that angle AIJ is 90 degree, it is given that IJ is perpendicular to AI. So this angle is also A by 2, that is equals to this one. This is A by 2. All right. And if this angle is A by 2, so in the right angle triangle JIY, we can write IJ also. What is IJ? IJ is, again, we know that IY is R. So if IY is R, then IJ will be equals to R sec A by 2 again. And as we know that triangle IJD is also right angled triangle, because IJ is perpendicular to AI. So IJD is right angled triangle. So in this right angled triangle, DJ is actually the hypotenuse, and that is equals to root over of ID square plus IJ square. Alright. Which is equals to R root 2 sec A by 2. So finally, using simple trigonometry, we have calculated DJ length. Similarly, we can find EK length. EK length we can find with the same construction and with same type of calculation, that is equals to R root 2 sec of C by 2. And as per the question, it is given to us that DJ is equals to EK. That means these two terms are equal. That means sec of A by 2 is equals to sec of C by 2, which clearly means that angle A is equals to C. And if angle A is equals to C, that means this is a right angled isosceles triangle, which means AB is equals to BC, that we have to prove. Alright everyone. Let ABC be a right angled triangle with angle B is 90 degrees. Let I be the in center of triangle ABC. Draw a line perpendicular to AI at I. Let it intersect the line CB at D. Prove that CI is perpendicular to AD, and prove that ID is equals to root over B into B minus A, where BC has length A and CA has length B. So first of all, let's draw the diagram. Here we have triangle ABC. As it is given, I is the in center. So AI, BI and CI will be angle bisectors. Now it is given that a line which is perpendicular to AI at I intersect BC at D. So now we are going to draw a line which is perpendicular to AI that is intersecting CB extended at D. So this is point D, this is point I. Now we have to prove that this CI line is perpendicular to AD. So we have to join A and D also. Now we have joined A and D. What we need to prove? We have to prove that this angle is 90 degree. We need to prove this. So how we can proceed for this question? First of all, we know that angle AID is 90 degree. This is 90 degree. As well, angle ABD is 90 degree. That clearly means that A, I, B and D are concentric points. So we can draw a circle through these four points like this one. Reason is simple here. These two angles are 90 degree. That means AD is diameter of a circle which passes through B and I. If these four points are concentric, then we can say clearly that AI subtend equal angle at circumference. So this angle is also B by 2, which is 45 degree, because this is BI is angle bisector of angle B and angle B is 90 degree. So this angle is 45. That is why angle ADI is also 45 degree. At the same time, we can say that BI also subtend equal angle at the circumference. This is angle A by 2. So this is also A by 2. This is A by 2. Now what is total angle ADB? ADB is 45 plus A by 2. Similarly, here also we have this angle A by 2 and this angle DAI also equals to 45 degree, because triangle ADI is right angled. So this angle is 45 degree. So what is total angle DAC? DAC is 45 plus A by 2. What is angle ADC? That is also 45 plus A by 2. That means we came to know that AC is equals to DC. That means triangle ADC is isosceles triangle. And we also know that CI is what? CI is angle bisector of angle C. And it is obviously clear that in isosceles triangle, angle bisector is same as the altitude. So this angle bisector means CI will be perpendicular to the base. AD means this angle is 90 degree. This is what we have to prove. We have to prove the second part also. Second part is we have to prove that ID is equals to square root of B into B minus A. So how we can prove this one, ID? Actually, we came to know that triangle ADI is isosceles. This angle is 45, this angle is 45, here angle I is 90 degree. So ID is equals to IA, we already know that. ID is equals to IA. Alright, also we can say that using Pythagoras theorem that AD is equals to root over of ID square plus IA square, that is root 2 times ID. Alright, and can we find AD? Of course we can find AD. How? Because triangle ADB is right angle triangle and we know that CD is equals to AC. That is why DB length is equals to CD minus BC, and as CD is equals to AC, so we can write it B minus BC, length is A. So DB is B minus A, and if DB is B minus A, AB is already C. So using Pythagoras theorem, we can find AD. AD is square root of C square plus B minus A square. As we know that we have to find the answer in terms of A and B only, so in place of C square we have to replace it as B square minus A square. So this is equals to B square minus A square plus b square plus a square minus 2ab. So a square is cancelled here. What we are getting it? It is root 2 times root over of b square minus ab. Alright? And if we replace ad here, then we will get id as ad by root 2, and ad by root 2 will be equals to b square minus ab. That is equals to root over b into b minus a. Hence proved. Alright? So we have used here simple geometry and trigonometry. Especially Pythagoras theorem, properties of cyclic quadrilaterals are also used here. Here we have one more question. Let ABC be a right angle triangle with angle B equals to 90 degree. Let E and F be respectively the midpoints of AB and AC. Suppose the in center I of triangle ABC lies on the circumcircle of triangle AEF. Find the ratio BC by AB. So first of all, as per the given information, we are going to draw the diagram. ABC is a right angle triangle. Here angle B is 90 degree. This is angle B. Let's say this vertex is A, this is C. Now, I is the in center of triangle ABC, which lies on the circumcircle of triangle AEF, where E and F are the midpoints of AB and AC respectively. So we mark E here and F here, and we will join E and F. This is E, this is F. Of course, triangle AEF is similar with triangle ABC, and it is given that the in center of triangle ABC lies on the circumcircle of triangle AEF. So first of all, we will draw circumcircle of AEF. We know that AEF is also right angle triangle, so its circumcenter will be the midpoint of AF. So here we are drawing the circumcircle of AEF, and let's say here is the in center I of triangle ABC. Alright, this is center of circumcircle. Let's say this point is K. As we know that these two are equal parts, as well F is the midpoint of AC. So if length of AC, generally we denote length of AC as B, so CF will be B by 2 and AF will be B by 2. Again AK is equals to FK, so both the parts are B by 4. This is B by 4, this is B by 4, and the remaining portion here is B by 2. If you join K and I, so here we are getting KI is equals to KF is equals to AK, because all are radius, all are B by 4. I am also joining A and I. So you can clearly observe that triangle AKI is isosceles. So this angle is same as this angle, and both angles are A by 2 actually, because AI is angle bisector. Then the angle IKF is equals to A by 2 plus A by 2, which is equals to angle A. Now, if we draw a perpendicular from I on AC, so we know that length of perpendicular is equals to in radius R, and in right angle triangle, let's say this foot of perpendicular is M. So in right angle triangle KIM, we can say that sine A is equals to IM, which is R, divided by IK, that is B by 4. Alright? So finally, we have established a relation, and what we need to find? We have to find BC by AB. So we denote BC as A and AB as C. So we have to find the ratio A by C. Now we will convert these relations into small a and small c. We know that B sine A is equals to 4R. What we can say, what is B sine A? So you know that B sine A, we can say this is A sine B. Alright? Because angle B is given as 90 degree, so we can simplify it as A. On the right hand side, it is 4R. And we know that R is actually S minus B tan B by 2. We are converting everything in angle B actually. Why? Because B is 90 degree given. So we can write it S minus B tan B by 2. Tan B by 2 is tan 45, which is 1. So this is finally 4S minus B. Here again it is A equals to 4S minus 4B. We know that S is A plus B plus C by 2. So A is equals to 2A plus 2B plus 2C minus 4B. Again, we can say that this is A plus 2C is equals to 2B. Also, we know a relation between AB and C, that is B square is equals to A square plus C square. And we have to find the ratio of A and C, so we will substitute the value of B here. If we substitute the value of B here, then we will get A plus 2C by 2 whole square is equals to A square plus C square. Or if we simplify this, we are getting A square plus 4C square plus 4AC is equals to 4A square plus 4C square. Alright, 4C square cancelled. Then we get 4AC is equals to 3A square. Or if we are interested to find the value of A by C, then A by C is equals to 4 by 3. So final answer of this question is 4 by 3. We have used simple trigonometric relations here, and we have used formula of small r, that is S minus B, 10B by 2. We have used sine rule that B sine A is equals to A sine B, and somehow we have calculated the ratio A by C. One more question is here. Let ABC be triangle in which AB equals to AC, means we are talking about the isosceles triangle. Suppose the orthocenter of triangle lies on the incircle, find the ratio AB by BC. This time we have been given an isosceles triangle. Let's say this is isosceles triangle in which AB is equals to AC. So this vertex is A, this is B, this is C, AB is equals to AC. Then it is given that the orthocenter of this triangle, so we will draw an altitude that will be also angle bisector. This orthocenter lies on the incircle of triangle ABC. So if we draw incircle of this triangle, so now we know that incenter, orthocenter, circumcenter, everything lies on this line AD. So here will be the orthocenter H. As per the given information, orthocenter lies on the incircle, so obviously the H will lie on this line AD as well in on this incircle, so H will be here. And now we have to find the ratio AB by BC. This is isosceles triangle, so let's assume this angle is theta. Of course this angle is theta. This is 90 minus theta, this is also 90 minus theta. Both the angles are 90 minus theta. Total angle is 180 minus 2 theta. And let's say AB is L, so base is L cos theta. This total height AD is L sin theta. And what we have to find? We have to find AB by BC. So what is AB? We have considered AB as L. What is BC? BC is actually 2L cos theta. Alright? So we have to calculate actually 1 by 2 sec theta. We have to calculate the value of 1 by 2 sec theta finally. Alright? How we are going to calculate? Actually, H is orthocentered, so we know the formula of AH. AH is 2R cos A. So it is 2R, R is circumradius of this triangle ABC, and cos A. What is angle A? Angle A is 180 minus 2 theta. So cos of pi minus 2 theta. Finally, it is minus 2R cos 2 theta. Alright? Also, HD. HD is equal to twice of in radius, and it means 2 times small r. We can also convert this into capital R, that is 2 into 4R sine A by 2, that is sine 90 minus theta, which is cos theta, sine B by 2, that is sine theta by 2, sine C by 2, that is again sine theta by 2. So we have calculated this value in terms of capital R also. And we know that this total height AD is equal to AH plus HD, means L sine theta. AD is what? L sine theta. L sine theta is equal to AH plus HD. AH plus HD is actually 8R cos theta sine square theta by 2 minus 2R cos 2 theta. And what is L sine theta? So we know that we can write L in terms of R also using sine rule. L is actually 2R, and opposite angle is theta, 2R sine theta into sine theta is equals to 8R cos theta sine square theta by 2 minus 2R cos 2 theta. So we can cancel 2r. Also we can convert the whole equation in terms of cos theta only. So after cancelling 2r, left hand side will be 1 minus cos square theta. This term will be 2 cos theta into 2 sin square theta by 2 will become 1 minus cos theta. And the last term is minus cos 2 theta, which is minus 2 cos square theta plus 1. We can cancel 1 here. Again, we can simplify this as 3 cos square theta equals to 2 cos theta, which means cos theta is equals to 2 by 3, because cos theta cannot be equal 0. Cos theta is equal 0, then theta will be 90, and triangle is not possible in that case. Alright, so cos theta is 2 by 3, and we need the value of sec theta. Sec theta will be 3 by 2, so final answer will be 3 by 4. So that was the trigonometry part of this chapter. We will continue this chapter with some theorems related with geometry, related with similar triangle and cyclic quadrilateral in the next lecture.